If you're not familiar with Google CoLab, it basically lets you run Python and other languages if you get creative in the cloud in a virtual machine that gives you access to a GPU as well. So you can run Python in Jupyter notebooks, again, other environments if you get creative, and experience your code on potentially a more powerful machine than what your local instance would be. If you're running a Mac, this is particularly useful because you can use a GPU that's actually compatible with things like Keras and TensorFlow, whereas Macs currently don't have NVIDIA GPUs and probably won't in the future because they're going more their own internal direction with the new M1, which is getting some support, but that's another topic. So what I want to talk to you about in this video is, and this is going to be a quick video, is CoLab Pro, where you pay extra money, worth it in first quarter 2021? And I put the date in here because this changes rapidly with CoLab as Google puts more and more features into this. So let's take a look. Oh, and if you could possibly like this video, that really helps with the YouTube algorithm. And if you want to see more of this kind of thing, please subscribe. So let's jump right into it. First of all, is CoLab Pro even available in your region? I have listed the regions here. So they've improved this a lot. It used to be just United States and Canada, which was unfortunate for the rest of the world. Most of the subscribers and people watching my channel seem to be first from the United States, with India a very, very close second, maybe even overtaking. Definitely go India. So let's get into the side-by-side comparison. I wrote a notebook here that you can compare the non-pro version versus the pro version. And the difference is $9 a month. So I think it's very much worth the $9.99 a month that they're charging US dollars. I am a subscriber of this and have been really since it first came out. You can look at the notebook that I have here. I'll have it linked in the description to this video so you can take a look and see where I actually got the data from. Let's look at the data a little more friendly of a format. Here you can see the two really side by side. CoLab Standard and Pro, they both have the same CPU on it. It's a 2.2 gigahertz. Now this is Xeon, so these tend to not be as super fast because their data center heat is everything there. Both have two cores, but the GPU that you get on these. Now, if you're watching this video in the future, this changes. I remember when this used to be primarily K80 on Standard. Now we see a lot more T4s. I have not seen a K80 in a while, and that's great because the T4s are faster. CoLab Pro, what I'm currently seeing in first quarter of 2021 is usually I get a V100, sometimes I get a P100. I'm not really sure how this works in terms of when you get what. Like, say, for example, I train GANs for a couple of days. Are they going to punish me and give me P100s in the future? I don't know exactly. Now, GPU memory, you're going to have 16 on the T4. So both of these are right at about 16 gigabytes. And 12 on the K80. This is really the sweet spot of what you want for space on your actual GPU. You can do a lot with this, and if you're hitting the ceiling, adjust your batch size. That's usually the best way to deal with this. System RAM is quite different. Now, you have to request the system RAM in the CoLab Pro environment, or you won't get it. And don't just request it for the heck of it. They detect if you're using their GPU or if you're using your system RAM or not, and they warn you about it and say, hey, you're being wasteful. So you want very much to make sure that you're using that efficiently. Is in theory, the Google AI watchers might throttle you. This is important. The virtual machine lifespan, 12 hours on Standard, and I routinely run these full 24 hours. Now, you have to do something so that they don't actually toss you out because they think you're no longer interacting with the system, and we'll see that in just a second. But for me, the V100 alone cinches this so that it's worth it. If you're going to be training GANs, and my next video is going to be on training GANs, on CoLab. So definitely take a look at that. Subscribe so you don't miss it. And this little bit of code here, I'll put this in the description. You can find this all over Reddit and Stack Overflow, but this basically shows you, this is JavaScript that you put right into the console. I'll show you that in a moment. And it's not going to time out on you. It will hit that 24-hour thing and it'll knock you off. But that is just the way that works. When you do hit that ceiling, you're going to see something like this. And you can also see all this stuff going on here. A lot of the yellow is just the normal vomit that JavaScript throws at you while it's running. I have never seen JavaScript on a website not just throw all kinds of war. It's JavaScript. It's the cockroach that survived the language wars of the web. But JavaScript is great. The web has ran on it. But what you'll see here is these connect push. That's my script basically running and keeping this thing active. Ultimately, when you hit the 24 hours, you will see this. Or if you hit the 12 hours, if you're not paying for CoLab Pro, this is a great product as well on pro or non-pro. And I'll do a little benchmarking between the two because I'm doing a video soon on how to train GANs on these. And I do want to show you the tremendous speed boost that you get for that V100 that NVIDIA has. And Google, if you ever want to add A100s to this, this would be great. I'm sure they will at some point, but I have no idea when that will happen. And then a few of the restrictions just to mention on this. The biggest one is you cannot sublet. So you can't go in on this with your friend and both of you share it. Kind of like Netflix and all of these. It's hard for them to police that, but probably don't do that. So basically the first three of these almost are all. So basically these can be summarized as don't mine cryptocurrency, don't use it to distribute software, and don't share your account with other people. Now, I will say some of the limitations that I find with this. First of all, the 24-hour thing is just a pain to me. I have to restart that manually. I'll show you how you can deal with that in the next video on how to train StyleGAN on this. For a business situation or for some of the research projects that I've worked on, that I just don't want to deal with that. I'll buy my own GPU and deal with it, or I'll run it in the cloud. Now, in the cloud, this is very similar to what you have to deal with around spot instances in Amazon, which can let you get basically a 70% discount on this. If you want to see a video on spot instances, definitely tell me. I'd be glad to do that. And by the way, no, you can't earn a profit on cryptocurrency with spot. And the day that you could earn a profit on cryptocurrency with AWS would be the day that AWS basically gets DDoS'd into the ground by crypto miners. Other limitation that I will say, and again, this gets to research and some of the business projects that I work on, you are at the whim of Google in terms of what software is installed. So if you want to run software that Google doesn't have, you have to uninstall all theirs and reinstall, and it's just hard to have reproducible research in CoLab. Because you can't just capture a Docker image or a requirements TXT or something like that and truly capture what your code was running. So that's definitely another complaint that I have. Also, whatever machine is running this, you've got to have that machine up and running, because if you just close your laptop, it's gonna time out. If you're going to take your laptop and go from home to Starbucks, one day COVID will be over and I can do that again, but you're going to lose your connection. Whereas if you're running this in the cloud or at home, I can remote connect into my machine or I can run it on the cloud. So it's not as professional as what you're going to see using the cloud or using your own GPU, but to get started, you just can't beat this. And I have advanced GPUs and I use the clouds, and I still make use of CoLab because for quick POC, this is great. And I don't necessarily want to interrupt my home GPU from whatever it's currently working on. So if you're not familiar with Jupyter notebooks, this is what CoLab actually looks like. And just to see how I train GANs in it, I'll put a more finalized version of it, but this is basically what I do to give you an idea of how I deal with the timeouts and things like that. I mount my G drive, And this is the only control that they give you as far as what versions of things that you're running. And I'm not even using TensorFlow, so I don't even know why I have this here. This is actually using PyTorch. But you mount your G drive, and then I am basically going to install whatever I want to run. In this case, it's StyleGAN 288 PyTorch. And then I'm going to run these commands because basically I want to run actual Python PY files, not Jupyter notebooks. So I will run this. In this case, I'm converting images. And you basically run all your commands like this. You get the output saved here. But the important thing is I am using my G drive to do all the checkpointing and storing my intermediate forms of this. That way, when inevitably this thing shuts me down, which you can see here, here I was training, moving happily along. Notice we're at like 20 hours here. And then bam, it's dead. Here was my last checkpoint. So that saved it to my G drive, and I can go retrieve the pickle file and continue so long as your software is designed to do that. And then these ticks that continued, they were wasted because they were ran on CoLab, but they were never checkpointed. It didn't get it. So this is a issue with setting your checkpoint size. Thank you for watching this video, and if you found this interesting, you want to see more about CoLab, I use it extensively in my YouTube videos because I want to make sure everything that I put out there is compatible with CoLab, because pretty much everything I do uses an NVIDIA GPU. And this is a way, if you don't have that kind of processing power on your actual computer, to be able to make use of what I put on the channel. So please subscribe to my channel and think about giving this video a like. Thank you very much.